Hello, welcome back to Learn Economia. Today we are going to discuss the idea of Keynesianism. This is a very popular idea that we know, but we have to understand the details of the very same. Let's consider the discussion here. In order to understand Keynesianism, we just need to start from the Great Depression of 1930s, because till this 1930s Great Depression, the world was actually following the classical school of thought. Now, the classical school of thought was not able to identify the cause of this worldwide economic collapse. Now, coming to Keynesian economics, Keynes could offer a solution to the 1930s depression. And also, he could identify the cause. So, he provided an adequate public policy solution to the problems that were there in the economy as a result of the Great Depression. Let's consider the details of the Keynesian economics now. To start with, Keynesian economics or Keynesianism had started with the ideas of John Maynard Keynes. And this person was proposing his ideas in his famous work, General Theory of Employment, Interest and Income. And he had overturned the prevailing considerations regarding free market. Actually, the classical economists, they always believed that economy would be attaining full employment. This was what the classical school believed. But Keynes, as far as Keynes is concerned, he believed that there do not exist something called full employment. Instead, what exists is something called underemployment equilibrium. It is not full employment equilibrium that exists, but instead it would be underemployment equilibrium that exists. And this person was giving emphasis to what is called the aggregate demand. He believed that aggregate demand is the main engine of growth, main engine as far as growth of the economy is concerned. Because when it comes to aggregate demand, it is the sum of the spending made by all the units. It covers the spending by household, it covers the spending by firms, also it covers the government spending as well. Now, the Keynesianism was actually giving emphasis to aggregate demand. This is what we told. Now, what about the free market? As per Keynes, free market with its demand and supply, the market forces, won't be having any self-balancing capacity in order to lead to full employment situation. So, there would be some problems in the economy that would be preventing the economy to attain a full employment equilibrium by itself. Keynes always believed in the limitations of a free market economy that prevents itself from being able to balance by itself. So what he suggests at this point is that we require an external force, and this is identified as government. There should be an intervention by the government. And how? The government will be framing some public policies. The government will study the scenario and the present scenario, and it will take appropriate policies that will suit the need. So public policies that aim to attain full employment as well as price stability would be taken by the government. So Keynesianism or Keynes, this kind of approach always emphasizes the role of the government to promote a stable situation in the economy. Keynesian idea is always considered as a revolutionary idea. As I've told you in the very beginning, till the 1930s, the world was actually taking the path and the ways given by the classical school of thought. But after 1930s, we couldn't find enough demand. There existed something called inadequate demand. And as a result of this inadequate demand, we had to cut short our production because people were not demanding anything. And what happened if we cut short production? The demand for labor will be coming down. And what happened when demand for labor comes down? This will create something called unemployment. So this will lead to increase in unemployment. And what happened when unemployment increases? Income would be coming down. Again, demand would be coming down. Again, production would be coming down. Again, unemployment would increase. So it would go as a cycle. Whenever we have to consider the aggregate demand, we should consider the consumption side, investment side, government, purchase, net export, that is export minus imports. So here, we need to think about the 1930s situation. And it was something called an extreme recession. And you call it as depression. Because it had reached the extreme stage. And what would happen when there is a depression happening? As a result of this depression, the demand will be coming down. So there would be a fall in the aggregate demand. People will not spend. They are afraid. And consumer will be losing their confidence. And coming to investor side, the marginal efficiency of capital would be coming down. Business firms will not make any investment. Because they are expecting something called a loss. At this point of time, nobody would be going for spending. Nobody would be going for investment. So, what to do in order to make the economy recover? Again comes the role of the government here. Government will come with something called autonomous spending. So, it is the responsibility of the government as per Keynes to moderate the booms as well as bursts in economic activity. The government has to take steps accordingly. It has to appropriate its steps based on the requirement. And Keynes was saying that as far as the aggregate demand is concerned, it has some effect. Also, it gets influenced by both private and public spheres. Even though classical school of thought believed in something called wage price flexibility, this is something believed by the classical school. Keynes never believed in wage price flexibility. Instead, he believed that these are rigid. So prices and especially the wages would be responding very slowly. There would be something like shortages, surpluses in between. And what about the changes in aggregate demand? It is told that whether it is anticipated or unanticipated, whether it is expected or unexpected, this will be having some effect as far as output and employment are concerned, but will not affect prices. It will not have any implication on prices. So that is why we have to see that price is something which is rigid as far as Keynes and Keynes as well as his followers. We call them as Keynesianism. The school of thought is identified in the name of Keynesianism. Prices are somewhat rigid. And simultaneously we have to consider the changes that happens in other arenas. Now, just come to the case of government spending now. What happens when the government spends? Whenever spending by the government increases, this will create an increase in income or increase in output because there is something that we call its multiplier effect working here. The multiplier effect involves the changes that is made to the income as a result of changes that happens in the spending. So if you consider multiplier as equal to 1, what we mean is that an increase in the government spending by $1 would be increasing the income or outcome or output. This is output by more than $1. This is what involves a multiplier effect. Now we have to consider something regarding stabilizing the economy. Keynesianism has got some idea as far as stabilizing the economy is concerned. So here we have to consider something known as the business cycle. Because the economy will not follow a constant growth path, or it will not follow a ever growing path. In between there will be fluctuations. It can be something like this. So there will be an upturn, there will be a downturn, there will be a depression, there will be a boom. We have to consider every aspect of a business cycle. What Keynes in this scenario says is that the government should be there. The government should intervene because we have to have some fiscal policies. We have to stimulate employment. We have to stabilize the wages. For that, we need government. Now, there was some other set of policy also we do have to deal with. Some economic fluctuations or economic issues. We call them as monetary policies. Or it's a set of monetary policy. But as far as Keynes, monetary policy would be ineffective during a period called liquidity trap. So when increase in money stock fails to lower interest rate, this will not create any impact on output and employment. But here comes the role of the government. When monetary policy fails, government can come to rescue the economy, to make it recover from the trap. And government can focus on some short-term implication. It can take some policies and can focus on the short-term implications on such policies. What you could see is that even though Keynes was giving certain ideas, certain solutions that made the economy to recover from the Great Depression of the 1930s. Keynesianism was not considered as an ever welcoming step. It was not a ever welcoming step. Because when Keynes was alive, Keynesianism or Keynes ideas got approval and support from diverse angles. But that doesn't mean that Keynesian idea did not get scrutinized. Keynesian idea too got some criticism. So these two received several criticism. Especially this came from the Austrian school of economics. They told that why Keynes was giving so much emphasis to the Great Depression of the 1930s. Because it's all about the business cycle. You will be having a depression, you will be having a boom, you will be having recession, recovery, everything. This happens. Economy will not go in a constant pace. Economy will not go in a ever increasing or ever growing way of movement. There will be some upturns, there will be some downturns in between. So recession as well as booms, these are natural. And since it is natural, why should the government intervene? This is a question that the Austrian School of Economics asks here. So what we could see is that the Keynesian idea was dominating the economic sphere after the World War II. Until 1970s, Keynesian economics was receiving support. But what happened was that there existed something called stagflation after that. So this happened to have a slow growth as well as inflation. It's a mix of inflation and unemployment. So it's something highly problematic. So Keynesian economics could not give any kind of explanation to this. So this made Keynesian economics to lose its popularity, because Keynes was not able to give some appropriate policy response to stagflationary tendency of the economy. Now comes the case with monetarists. Monetarists involve another school of thought which got pioneered by Milton Friedman. And under this school, those people who supported Milton Friedman, they doubted the ability of the government to go for regulation in the scenario of stagflation. They always stood for something called a long and short run kind of implication. So there in such a scenario required an understanding of both the long run neutrality of money as well as the short run idea. Because we have to consider both the real variables as well as the nominal variables simultaneously. In certain cases, we could see that stock of money would be affecting the nominal variables like prices, wages, but it won't be affecting the real variables like employment, output, etc. Now, we have to consider a very, very important idea. Because both Keynesianism as well as monetarism, both these schools of thought were criticized. Both these came under scrutiny. And this is being done by a new classical school. This is done by the new classical school. And this happened in the 1970s when the Keynesian school was not able to provide any solution to the stagflation. So they said that coming to the policy makers, this is something ineffective because individual market participants would be able to form something called anticipation. They would be able to anticipate the changes from a given set of policy so that it will make such people to act in advance so that it would be counteracting the policies. In such instances, sometimes the policies would be ineffective. Now comes something called a new generation of Keynesianism. Here, they said that no, people, even though they might be able to anticipate the scenario very correctly, the market might not be clearing instantaneously. They require something called time. You need time. There should be some time for adjustment. So fiscal policy can take that gap, and in such a situation, you need government to intervene and fiscal policy would be effective. Now, again, during the 2007-08 financial crisis, the global financial crisis, which got started in the US and experienced and felt in all over the world, the Keynesian theory got a very sudden comeback because the people as well as policymakers were going back to Keynesianism by supporting the role of government in recovering the economy from the crisis. So we were going for several stimulus packages, fiscal stimulus packages. Even when the monetary policy became ineffective, fiscal policy became effective. And this is what we could see in the case of many countries, not only in the developed countries like US, but also in the case of India and several other economies. But there exists a small problem with the approach here, because we have to integrate the financial system here. We have to integrate the real and financial sectors here. And this integration would make Keynesian approach a perfect one as far as the situation that demanded during the 2007-08 crisis is concerned. So many economists have supported the Keynesian approach, and they wanted the economy to use such approach during the 2007-8 period depression. And one famous example is like the Nobel laureate economist Paul Krugman. This person was strongly supporting the Keynesianism idea during the 2007-8 period, and he was arguing and telling and giving some recommendation to the government to go for Keynesian ideas, to make some fiscal stimulus packages, to implement some huge and powerful fiscal stimulus packages for the powerful revival of the economy, for the economy to recover. So that is how it happened. That is how the economy recovered. So what we could see is that the 2007-8 crisis was actually giving a opportunity. It was a chance and opportunity for the Keynesian economics to come back with respect to its implementation. So that's it all about Keynesianism. Thank you for watching. I hope you could get some idea related to Keynesianism. I request you to like, share, and subscribe to this channel for more videos. I'll be providing the link of our Telegram community in the description box, so you can join our free Telegram community. Also, I request you to download the Learn Economy app. For that also, I'll be providing the link in the description box. That's it. Thank you for watching.